snapshot 25W03A brought us Datapack version 63 and Resource Pack version 48, with a first public version of the Minecraft gameplay test framework, new components for entity variants, new functionality for item models, and more. My name is Sly Slime, and this is a video about all the changes. Let's start with item components, where a set of new entity variant components have been added to configure aspects of appearance for mobs related to the items. These components are applied to the entity when used with any item that spawns an entity, like spawn eggs, paintings, and fish buckets. These components include variant components for villagers, wolves, foxes, parrots, mushrooms, rabbits, pigs, frogs, horses, llamas, axolotls, cats, and paintings. There are also collar components for sheep and shulkers, as well as collar components for cats and wolves. For tropical fish, there are three components for pattern, base color and the pattern color, and for salmon, there is a single size component. These components are now used by items from the creative inventory. Note that currently, these components do not get set when using a pick block to get a spawn egg. There are also other component changes. The equipable component can now also apply to the saddle slot, and has a new boolean field called Equip on Interaction, which determines if the item can be equipped on a mob by interacting with it. This only works if the target mob doesn't already have an item in the relevant slot. If not specified, the default value is false. The body slot is no longer special, and as long as the equipable component has it set, and the allowed entities field matches, the equipment can now be added into that slot. And the weapon component field damage per attack has been renamed to item damage per attack. Entity predicates now have a new field called components. This field matches components on entities, which for now only include the entity variant component, and those components are not actually stored as components the same way as on items. The format is the same as components on item predicates, and in the same way, these component predicates are an exact match against the full component data. A number of previous sub-predicates have now been replaced by these new component matches. In command news, the saddle of any mob is now a proper equipment slot, which can be referenced from anywhere that expects an equipment slot, like for the item command. The horse.saddle slot no longer exists. Note that the saddle slot only renders anything for mobs that normally support having saddles, and that adding a saddle to something that can't normally be ridden does not automatically make it rideable. Items in the saddle slot otherwise work like other equipment slots and can have attributes and such. A couple of command bugs have also been fixed, with the X rotation of the teleport command no longer being restricted to 90 degrees of change from the entity's original angle. And the set block command has been fixed to now properly communicate changes of block entities to the client, so changes to blocks whose visuals depend on the block entity data now show up properly. In data news, the armor and hand items fields have been merged into an equipment map, which maps equipment slot ID to the equipped item. This equipment field now also supports the new saddle slot, which is now used instead of the saddle item on horse-like mobs and replaces the saddle boolean on pigs and striders. And the fall distance field has been changed from a float into a double value and renamed into snake case fall distance. In tag news, there's a new entity type tag called Can Equip Saddle for entities that can be interacted with to equip a saddle. And a follow-up from the text component changes in the previous version. The Show Text action for hover events now uses the field Value instead of Text. This pack version also introduces the Minecraft Gameplay Test System. This is a system for automatic test cases of the way the game behaves. Every test case is an individual structure meant to run in isolation and test that something happens. This system is accessible to both data packs and mods with different interfaces. It is much more flexible to use from code. A gameplay test is a combination of a test structure and a test instance asset. For code-based tests, this asset also points out how to access the right code to drive the test. When a test runs, the structure is loaded in and the corresponding code is run, if there is any. Each test is represented by an asset in the test instance registry. These assets have a number of entries describing how long the test should run and the circumstances of how they should run. The test instance also has a type, which is one of function and block-based, where function tests require some function to be added in code, and block-based tests run entirely using blocks in the test structure. The test instance asset also describes which structure to use with a namespaced ID and the namespaced ID of a test environment, which we'll get into later. Note that while the documentation says that the test environment field is environment, the actual field name used is batch. For block-based tests, the structure is expected to contain at least two of a new type of block, the test block. This block has four different modes: start, log, fail, and accept. Each test is required to have at least a start and an accept block. When the test starts, the start block emits a single tick redstone pulse. All the other block types are redstone receptors and perform some action related to the test when they trigger, logging a message to the game log, failing the test with a given message, or successfully completing the test. For code-based tests, instead of using test blocks, the mod is expected to add a test loader to the game, which adds test functions. Each test function is a method that accepts a game test helper instance in official mapping terms. That helper can be used to do many things, including summoning mobs and items, summoning mobs without their AI enabled, making mobs walk to certain places, and so on. The helper also has methods for asserting about the development of the state in the test, and support for making sequences of events and requirements. Each test also runs in a test environment. An environment is basically a set of global conditions like the time of day, weather, and game rules. A test environment is added to the test environment registry and is a typed object that can do things like set game rules, weather, time of day, or more generally, run command functions for setup and teardown. When any test is started, the setup and teardown of the environment is applied to make sure that the test has the right conditions to run. To create a test, start by creating a datapack with the test instance asset and any environment it needs. You can then enter the game and use a new command called test. This command has a number of options, but to begin with, the test create subcommand is used to set up a new test. Use it with the ID of your test instance to create a setup in the world with size of the text structure in the following argument. Note that this is meant for running in a flat world and will nuke a piece of the world around you to place the setup. This gives you a test instance block and a structure space with the bottom of bedrock and visible outline. Interact with the test instance block to view or manipulate the settings for the test. This allows you to save the test structure, reset the state and load it back in, as well as changing the size and settings of the structure. After building and saving the test structure, you can also run the test by interacting with this block and hitting the Run Test button, or by using the test command again with the Run Closest subcommand. The test command also has more functionality for running one or more tests that already exist without having to load them in one by one. Running tests this way is one way to run them, but the server jar now also has a new entry point that can be used to start an automated run of tests. This can be used for fully automated test runs like what is wanted on CI systems. This creates a superflat world and runs all the tests in the provided pack. And with that, we're going to leave the test framework and move on to resource packs. There's a new property for select item models called component. This matches the content of an item component, so for instance you can compare the contents of the item's name or the variant name of a painting. As opposed to all existing properties for the select item models, the expected format of cases is whatever the data is for that component type, which might not be a string. And equipment assets can now also define saddle-related layer types. Saddle textures are now outside of camel and horse textures, and pig and strider saddle textures have changed as well. The size of the pig saddle texture has also changed. And that brings us to the end of the pack changes for this version. Thank you for watching. Below the video, you can test pressing the like button. My name is Sliced Lime. I'll see you next time.